I don't know why people are driving over the parking spaces. Please don't do that. Oh, man. I'm really messing this up, aren't I? Whoa, mama. Hello, everybody, and welcome back to City Skylines with me, Biffa. And here we are in New Tealand. And this piece of land that lays before us here is the project for today. I asked you all to vote and to give me your suggestions on Twitter, on my YouTube community post, on my Discord. Are you on my Discord? You really want to be on my Discord. There's like so many people on there talking all about City Skylines. We're at the moment up to almost 41,000 members on the Discord, which is fantastic. But getting back to the subject at hand, I asked you what we're going to do with this piece of land, and there were so many votes. Business district, golf courses, theme parks. The biggest one was tourist and entertainment area, because we are near to the airport. Well, I put that in. This is the cargo airport, but we're near to this hub. The airport's not too far away. So I'm thinking we can pick out some of the best buildings that have been added to the game recently and really make this something special over here. Now, just before we dive in and do that, we're going to be, you know, attracting loads and loads of tourists into this area. And we want to make that as easy as possible for everybody here. Now, we've got this down here, which was sort of placed here many, many episodes ago. And we've never actually used it. And if we check underground, it does connect to this metro that goes through here. So what I'm going to do is actually remove those stops that are on there, because we're going to monkey with this a little bit. And let's have a look. Yeah, we're on that. Oh, I've got this turned off up here, haven't I? Yeah, there we go. So we're going to remove those, and then we're going to delete this whole thing. Yep, and the road as well, and everything. There we go. We don't want to mess anything up. And then we will put a metro back in there at some point. But for now, let's just hook that up, keep things going. Is it underground? Yes, it is. Excellent. No one's panicking. So we're going to need access off of this road. The train lines come in and cargo goes there. This one splits off and comes into our super mega hub that we made before. Thank you very much for all of your comments on this build that we've had. And also this build over here, forgot to attach a road. We've now got that in, so it's good. There was also someone said about a one-way road that I've left in over here. Now that I'm here, I've just remembered it. So we're going to switchify that one out. I think that was the only other one. These are one way to go all the way around anyway, which works out okay. Oh yeah, this one here doesn't need to be. Oh yeah, that's one way. Yep, we're fine. So people come into the train, and then of course they've got the metro options and the hub, all sorts of options that are going all over the place. So they can hook up, yeah, this yellow line here, which comes into our, this one over here, the Tarantula hub they can come from. So can they get from here? That is what I want to look at. We do have other metro lines here, so we could run another one underneath the airport. Oh, we've got this one here. We could use that one, and we can have the other one. So that one can be for this area, and then we can have a double one in here. Excellent. So first of all, let's get an interchange off of this highway sorted, because the highway comes in and out in all sorts of directions. Just a small one that will help us get people in and out of this area. Okay, there we go. We've got the most of it set up. We're just going to do some lane mathematics here. So we've got three lanes. One lane goes off, so it goes down to two. So that gives us a little bit more space to work with as well. There we go. Excellent. So now we get a dedicated lane going off, and you can do that on vanilla, which is absolutely fantastic. Then we're going to use node controller, and we're just going to square all of these up. There we go. Excellent. Looking a lot better. And then when where these come on down here, we want to help them out with a bit of Hugo there. So we'll get our lane connectors. Control S, Hugo there. You get a lane each, which is great. And when you come out over here, Hugo there, you get a lane each as well. And then the only thing we want to change up the top here is where it comes up. We want to change this into two lanes. So we're happy to have one lane coming off. But if we can go up into two lanes, that would be good. So probably this two-lane highway one again. That's going to end up going a bit weird if we do that. There we go. Excellent. And then we'll do the same over here. And then we're going to monkey with this a tiny bit once we've straightened that out. And we'll do the same over there. We'll straighten that out. Excellent. And then we don't want anybody going straight over. So I've got traffic lights in here at the moment. What I'm going to do is remove those. So no traffic lights. We're going to do give way. as you come up there, and hopefully that's okay. And then we're going to say nobody can go straight over, because, you know, if they're going to go straight over, they might as well take the highway. So we're going to do that, and that should be good. And I think with this as well, we'll make that dedicated, and we'll make that dedicated. You've got a straight on and an off, and then hopefully everybody can use that with no problem at all. And it looks like we're getting auto save quick sippity moment as well. Are you after a strong, sturdy mug for your cups of tea or coffee? It works for both if you really have to. Well, how about our new Cool Beans mug, now available on biffaplaysmerch.com. And of course, that one there, we can have a dedicated, and that one there, we can have a dedicated. Excellent. I just want to check the speeds on all of these. So what have we got? 60, 60, 50. Yeah, so nobody should be taking a shortcut through. That'll work. So now we've got a local intersection here for bringing people into this area. We've got this train line that is way up in the air. I am wondering whether just to bridge this whole piece along here, or we could just have a tunnel going through. Let's just see how that looks. Yeah, the tunnel didn't look good. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab these and I'm going to upgrade them. So they are raised pieces, like so, all the way down here, as these are raised pieces anyway, so it shouldn't be a problem. There we go. Excellent. Is that a raised piece? It is. So now maybe we can just smoothify this piece of land out just a little bit here and give us something to work with. There we go. Excellent. We will remove those. And we got some rocks to save. There's been a lot of rock movement in this episode, but we are going to grab these three here and we are going to take those. I'm going to have to move these over. There we go. That one as well. We are going to grab them. Aha! And take them all the way over to Alien Rock Park. Can you see it in the distance? We're coming upon Alien Rock Park. Whoa! There we go. A little bit of do-si-do as we get there. Excellent. Where shall we pop these? I think these ones could go right in. I'm going to put that one there, and then I'm going to move these ones in a bit. There we go, Alien Rock Park, looking fan-flipping-tastic. So now the question is, can we get a road underneath here? Let's get rid of our tree brush. I know we've got some things in the way there, but we'll sort those in a moment. If we bring that straight across there, excellent. And then we can use these to go either side, like so, and that is plenty of space under there. Brilliant. So now we've got our road access down here, and where is our metro? Our metro was running. Yeah, the metro can sort of be adjusted as we go along, so we'll see what happens with that. But let's take a look at some of the items that I would like to pop in. So the first one I'd like to use is this conference center. This is from the Africa in Miniature content creator pack. And this is just an amazing building. So if I pop that there, we're going to grab that and we're going to do a bit of maneuvering around. But let's just take a look at this thing. It just looks fantastic. Very low, but got some great detail on it. I really like this. We can add some parking in here as well. But I just think that looks fantastic. So we're going to have that in here. We also have along here the Grand Pier, which looks absolutely brilliant. This is the Grand Pier from Western Supermare, a place in the UK. And I just think I want this pointing out on that little tip there. And then we're going to work some magic around that, some pedestrian stuff. What I would like to do is continue this key wall around here for that to sit on up to this point. And then we've got some beach over there. There we go. I think that looks okay. Now, I would use this new one here, but I think there's a bug with it. A lot of people have used this, and it seems to be maxing out their path, something or other, path units in the game. So I'm just thinking at the moment, I'm not going to touch it. We're just going to go with what we've got. We may switch this all out for something else, but we'll see. That just seems a lot lower than everything else. That's just the way the land is going. We'll see what happens with that. Let's grab our Grand Pier and see if we can pop that right on that corner like that. And just take a look at this for a moment. Oh, this just looks fantastic. What's it got in here? It's got some shops and things. I don't know whether people are going to be walking up and down here, but I guess we'll soon find out. Nice little covered area. I'm assuming there's all sorts of games and things you can do in there. And then it brings you right up to over here, which is brilliant. Let's just maybe lower this down. I think I'd like that to rest on here if possible. Yeah, like that. That's okay. We can work with the bit underneath. Excellent. And then we're going to go for a pedestrian area here. So again, we're going to remove some of these trees and rocks. What I'm going to do, I think, is remove all the trees because I'm sort of doing it a few at a time and then keep going back to do more. We'll leave that up there. Let me collect all the rocks together. There we go. All the rocks are over there now. And yep, that's looking good. So we, what the heck was that? Oh my goodness me. A very loud airplane coming down over the top. Very good. So obviously this was a little bit too low. We seem to be flooding a bit, but we'll work with that. We'll see what happens. Right. So I would like a road that comes straight out the back of this and runs along the side. And like I said, we're going to make this a pedestrian road, if at all possible. A pedestrian, yeah, walking road. Street is the word I'm looking for. I'm thinking of maybe going for, let's have a look. So we've got that sort of darker colour. We've got the lighter colour. Let's have a look at that one, which does sort of nicely blend in with the key wall. And we've got the, that's the blue stone, isn't it? Yeah, and then we've got the cobblestone, which we haven't used too much of. And I quite like that cobblestone one. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to grab, let's have a look, this one here. And we're going to use one of our tools. So we're going to grab the parallel one. Here we go, this one here. Let's see if we go from, let's go from right in the corner. Boink, and have a look. The rock survived. Yeah, we can do a bit of work on that. So that brings us round to this part, and then if we can get a street, so I'm going to delete that final part. I want to see if I can get a street coming out that's straight with this one here. I think that is a pretty darn not quite straight road. I thought it was straighter than it was. Oh, I don't know. From this angle, it looks okay. From this angle, it looks like it's going off a bit. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to start drawing it from down here, right in the middle, and I'm just going to go straight out. And if that lets me line it up like that, that should be okay. I should have paused. And then if I delete from here and hold it down, I should be able to go all the way along, and that now should be straight. And then we're just going to use the move it mod to get that to the same height as everything else. And I think I set that to the same height as everything else, and it didn't change, did it? Control H, the same height as that. Thank you very much kindly. And then we can grab this and we can draw this all the way in if it lets me, game. Not quite sure how we're going to end this piece, but there we go. So now people can get in and out, which is good. And if I set this also to the same height as that, it actually goes up. Which is a bit confusing, because to me that would need to go down to be the same height. But yeah, we can furtle with that and we can get it so it works. Excellent. So let's just connect to this little road up here. Right, so with that road coming down here, or that street, I keep calling it a road, it's a street, isn't it? Then what I want to do is add this onto the middle of here. All sort of working this out as we go along, which I quite like. And I love the fact that you could be sat in here looking down the pier as well. Yeah, we'll definitely be changing these trees out at some point, I'm sure. Let me just put this path in again, but I'm going to put it a bit nearer this time, and I'm probably going to just cut that corner across there. So then it's going to end up looking like this. There we go. Excellent. Much nearer and looks a lot better. Cool. Right. Okay. So we've got those two in there. Let's keep the game running so we can make some money while we're building. I've also picked out, so we've got Grand Central Station, which I really like. I love this building. And I think this could be something really cool that people could come and visit as well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to plop that down and we're going to see if we can just sort of maneuver that into a position that makes sense. We've put all this in here and everybody's freaking out. Please stop flooding everywhere. That would be great. And I think if that could take in this little corner piece here, and then we could do a little bit of work on getting this all lined up and flattened out. But at the minute, we're just sort of going for the ideas. I really like this pedestrian street market hall, another unique building, which has got Is that just a built-in pedestrian street? Yeah, it is. Yeah, excellent. Okay, and if we could have that coming off the end here and then working with the land, that would be good. Let's just pop that in there and take a look at how that connects up. Yeah, I like this. Sort of going into the beach area just a little bit. A little bit built up here, so we might put something along the side. And then that just extends into the beach. So we'll work on that. I'm liking that. Is that messing with the view? That is messing with the view. Okay, we're not going to put that there. Let's find somewhere else for that instead. Let's pop that in here. Yeah, all the problems. I know. Yeah, that's much better. So if you're going to walk up from the beach, you might walk up and use some of the items here. I'd like to maybe change this so it's the same color as everything else. Is there variations on here? There isn't. So if we use this tool here and unlock this segment through the middle, there we go. And then we'll grab this one without the trees. So that version there, upgrade that. Fantastic. And then we'll go back in and lock it again. Very good. And that matches in with this area nicely. And then we also have a whole load of condos. Some of these were used before. You might remember when we built this area over here. We popped a couple of condos in, and that fits in really well. But we've got some different ones that we could use down here. Maybe sort of fill in some of this space. I mean, over here, we're getting into the foggy area, but certainly some of this space over here could be built up with some condos. I think that would look good. And we've also got some City Skylines 2 items that have been put together. We've got this unique ploppable building, which if we could put that right behind here, I think that would look very nice. Let's just see if we can line that up there. So we've got the City Skylines 2 logo right behind here. Looking very cool, very cool. And then we've also got, let's go back in to find it. So we've got like a little monument, and we've got a little monument in a park, and then we've got this water fountain. I don't really like the water fountain, to be honest. But this little ploppable park plaza is tiny. It is a lot smaller than I thought. Let's just pop that there and take a look. Oh, that is so teeny and so tiny. This monument here, let's just drop all of these down so we don't place a million of them. There we go. That is what they look like. So maybe we'll do a little something with that as well. So let's try and work out. Actually, before we do that, let's just try and put a little road in here. I think all these rocks and things are going to end up staying in here. We could sort of make that look nice with a few choice trees in here. What have we got that's going to look nice over here? I'm not quite sure. Oh yeah, I'm gonna have a couple of those in there just to build up the height a little bit. Oh, these red ones, I love them. Maybe something like, I don't really want to block the views that they're going to have out of here. Maybe just a couple of jacarandas, and I do feel like I want something slightly larger in the center that's not going to block the view. Or maybe that, just like that. Yeah, let's leave it like that. What tree could we use along here that's going to look nice? Gotta be honest, I think a straight up palm tree is just looking great down here. That really goes with the vibes of what this area is going to be. Oh my goodness, my eardrums are going to explode. There we go. Excellent. I don't think I've missed any. Nope, that would look good over there. Very nice. Oh, just thinking of the parks we can put in here as well. Very good. So now let's take a quick look over here. We've got to connect this road up, obviously, and get our pedestrian area working. Where our condos are going to go? So I'm actually thinking of the condos to be over here, sort of facing this beachfront area, which means we're going to have a road run along here. But then, of course, because all of this is pedestrian streets, we're going to need another road. So I think that is going to run along the railway line down here. So let's just pick, I mean, it doesn't have to be anything too huge. We can always upgrade it later if we want. Two-lane road with sidewalks will be good. And then we're going to get the parallel tool here. And which way are we going to go? I know people tell me you can use tab to put it over the top. I could, but unfortunately, my tab is used for one of my, let's go from here, we'll grab that, one of my camera mods, so it sort of messes things up. I think we'll probably come all the way down to here. Yeah, and then we'll stop there. So let's come out a bit. What I am going to do is end up raising this up as a bridge piece, so don't worry about this road being right up in the air, because we're going to do that. And then, oh yeah, it's all made it all a bridge piece. Oh, okay, very good. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab this road here. We're going to change that to road height. Change that to grab the road, whatever mode that is called. And then we'll do this here, Control H, and that's the height I want all the way along here. So I'm just going to grab all of these nodes. There we go. And then we'll Control H all of those down to this height. Oh, and we missed one. Let's grab that one. Control H down to there. And then I'm going to actually grab this road again. Is that the same one? No, it was this one here, wasn't it? And we're going to change all of these to this type of road. Oh, I still missed one there, but never mind. We'll grab that in a sec. There we go. Excellent. And then while we're doing this, I'm going to grab this railway line and we're going to make that into a raised railway line all the way along here. And where it splits off, and I'm wondering whether that bit as well. Do you know what? I might just do that bit there. I think that'll work a little bit better. There we go. Excellent. And then we can smooth this out, this little bit over here. So we're going to take that from there to over here. Oh, got to grab this node in the middle where it changes from there to there. Yeah, that'll do. And we'll do the same from there to here. And that'll do. Yeah, that'll be fine. Excellent. Oh, this one here. Let's try that again. This will be like the third time I've done this one. Control H to there. Excellent. So now we've got a road running along there, which is good. We move trees onward. And then we can build off of that. Oh, also got a nice rock. Let's pop that down the beach. Yeah, we can build off that and we can connect that over here as well. Actually, I'm thinking about increasing this road. We're going to take this one here. So it's still wide sidewalks, but it's got trees on it as well. As I think this is probably going to get quite busy down here, which is fine. And then this road here, we're going to continue this down, but we are going to have some sort of roadway network in here as well. So let's just swing that around into there. There we go. So that's access into our pedestrian area. Got the nice bollards on the end. And then if we need some more roads over here for services and things, we can do that. Let's just continue with this road. There we go. And then when we come down here, this road can literally snap right into there, which is fantastic. So now we've got access all the way along here. And then this sort of area here, let's just get rid of some of these trees. There we go. We'll get rid of it down to there. We've got this sand sort of seems to go back a little bit too far. I'm just wondering whether I can get rid of that. Which one of these is sand? That's pavement. Sand. That's this one here, isn't it? It never worked. No, it isn't. It's not that one. I know where it is. It's hidden in here somewhere. Here it is. That's the one in the landscaping. I know it's never in the place that you think it's going to be. And we're going to try and just get rid of a bit of that and add a little bit more there. Ooh, it's not sand. Well, what the heck's that then? Oh, there it is. It was. Oh, okay, fine. Yeah, excellent. And we've got a nice little beach down there. Very good. And then I think the road that we are going to have along here is going to be this road. I think that would work very well. And then we'll have our condos back in onto this. But then we have got access. Is that a bit too close for the beach? So they're going to walk out here and literally walk down on the beach. I feel like it just needs to be back just a tiny bit. Yes, we've got a little bit of space in there as well, so that'll work out okay. We'll go down to there. We can swing that around. How far around can that go? That can literally go all the way. Oh, that was close. Got to save the rock. Round to there. Excellent. So then anything we place along here, I've still got road access at the back. Very good. Let's have a look at the condos that we've got available to us. So a lot of the condos we've got here are from Thomas, their Palm Beach series. Some of them are sort of smaller Palm Beach houses. Some of them are just humongous. And I was thinking we'll have a couple of these sort of larger condos, but I was hoping we could go for sort of these smaller ones along here and they wouldn't take up too much space. So like these houses, if I put in Palm Beach house, we've got one. Ah, okay. Well, maybe let's just have a look through here. I'll pick some out and we'll see how we go with them. And to help with this, I've just added in another filter, picked building height and gone for 20. That seems like if we go for 30, you start getting these taller buildings in. Go for 25. I mean, you're getting these ones in here, which aren't too bad. So yeah, actually, I think 25 will do. And then we've got a few smaller houses along here. So I would like to, why has that changed? Oh, yeah, for meters. There we go. So let me grab some of these. We're going to lay these out and see what they look like. So I'm just looking at these ones here. We seem to have a different part. So we've got K condos A, B, I'm assuming that's C. Then we've got the centre part. Then we've got the garages. We've got a pool and we've got a reception. So I'm just wondering whether we could build that into an area somewhere, maybe a little bit further back here, I think will work. Let us just delete that and we're going to extend that out to here. There we go. And then see what we can do with this. I'll leave those buildings down there and we'll delete those if we use them. So we've got the reception building already exists. Okay, well, fine. What I'm going to do is use the move it mod. We're going to grab that, 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 and that. And we're going to delete it and that. We're going to delete it. And then I can do whatever I like. So we'll go with this one here. So we'll pop in the reception. Now, I don't know whether this has got a particular way it should be built, but we are going to do what we can. So that says center. Let's just pop that against the road there and have a look. So yeah, there's doors coming each and every way out of those. Okay. There's going to be a way of doing this, isn't there? Let's pop them down. So they're all going to want road access as well, which isn't going to make it very easy. So I've actually taken a look at the listing that is on the workshop, and it seems like they're not sort of meant to all hook together, but they're supposed to sort of go, let's have a look, something like this. And you can have them, I mean, obviously you can do what you like with them, but yeah, I thought they were supposed to hook together in some sort of square formation. But this little reception here has got these gates which nicely fit over a road there, which looks good. And then this center place is just basically where people can go play ping pong indoors if going down the beach is a little bit cold or something like that. So what I'm doing, I'm trying to start the movie mod. There we go. So I'm trying to sort of build these off of their own little road. If I bring that out to there and then sort of go up there, and then we can line these all up with a nice view of the beach. That's what I'm trying to do. That's the idea. Okay, so I've placed a few of the garages along the back there, and I'm just wondering actually whether we could upgrade some of these roads into these roads. So we can get some parking right outside where they are. We'll probably put some along there. This one here, I'm thinking, yeah, we'll pop some road parking out there as well. And then I can easily fill in all of these gaps here with some of these like this. There we go. Already got people coming over here, parking up and going in to enjoy the wonderful view. So whichever one of these you're in, you're going to have fantastic views of these areas. I know there's these little things out the back here, and you've got like a road and a railway line, but you've got the lovely mountains as well, and we'll have a load of trees around there, but popped in a couple of pools. But wherever you're staying, yeah, the views are going to be fantastic, and I like the way that all looks. And if we come down here, we've got these condos along the front, which I think fit in really, really well. Obviously, we've got to add our little palm trees in there, and we could even extend this sand further up this piece of land here, and I think that would look a lot better. Let's fill all of this in. There we go. So you're literally stepping out your house, crossing over the pedestrian street straight onto the beach with the great big rocks. Excellent. There we go. Nice little bit of detail there. I think that looks nice. Very good. Right. Things are ticking along here nicely. I've got power and water over to almost all of this. We obviously need to sort out our pedestrian zone, but we'll get to that in a moment. Let's just flatten the land out a little bit over here. Boom, boom, boom. We'll grab this, grab that. We're going to this height. Let's put that up all the way. There we go. Excellent. Because I want to put behind here, ooh, got to be careful, a sunken plaza. Just push that back a little bit. There we go. Excellent. So I want this behind here. So I'm going to place it there like so. And then I'm going to use the move it mod. And we're going to just drag that through here. And I want that sort of attached to the back of here, which actually now I'm thinking about it. If we just grabbed one of these pedestrian streets and drew that through here as straight as we could, then we can connect that to the back of here. And that would nicely not be quite straight because, you know, they always do that, don't they? There we go. Something like that. So we've got this you can come and have a look at. Then you've got the sunken plaza to do some shopping, which will be good. And then, of course, this also needs to connect over here. Yep, there we go. That's fine. Right, okay. So let's pop in the district that we need here. So all of this basically needs to be one big pedestrian zone. Here we go. We'll do something like that. I don't want it too large because it's going to cost us a load of money. I do want to just sort of bring it down and take in this section because this is where we're going to put the items that need to look after the services in this area here. And also now, with the building spawn point, there we go, excellent. We can drag these around, which is fantastic. So cargo truck and post, which one is that one? That middle one there, garbage truck. So we can change where we want these to come in and out. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab one new road, this one here. And we're going to have that sort of along the back here, like so. And that is where they're going to come in and out, rather than at the front. So if we grab this again... So this one is disaster response. So we don't need garbage truck on that one because we've got another one for garbage truck. So we'll remove that. We don't need cargo truck and we don't need post. Everything else I will leave on there. And then we'll move these ones. So that's this middle one here. If you click it and drag it, I don't know whether you can turn it around. Oh, it's gone. There we go. No, I think we still need to use this to turn it around. There we go. So I've got all those lined up at the back there, which is where I think they should come in and out. We'll still get some cars and things popping in and out on there, but that's okay. And then we just need to add our water pipes under the road. And yeah, there we go. They'll start taking care of all of those needs. The power will jump across momentarily. I'm liking the look of this. Going to need some detailing, but we're getting there. We're getting there. And I'm just thinking about a few little shops just around here, just to sort of help this area out. Again, they're going to be inside this pedestrian zone. If I go up the side there with that, does that clip? Yes, it does. So if we use the move it mod, I'm going to grab that there. I'm going to move that away so it doesn't clip anymore and line these up. Oh man, I'm really messing this up, aren't I? Whoa, mama. Okay, I think we've got it. I'm going to remove that connection there because it's all a bit weird. And I wanted another road down the side here, which isn't too bad. There we go. And then if we just sort of shiftify that a tiny touch, we can get that all nicely lined up. And it just means then we can have a few shops along here. And I'll be thinking in here, we're going to use the ones from the new Shopping Malls Content Creator Pack. And I think I'm going to just go through here and pick out a few of the lower buildings like this, which I think would look very nice along here. What have we got? That's a restaurant, level 2. So definitely a small little restaurant in here would be nice. Oh, there we go. Yeah, people can sit there and enjoy some of the views out the back. Very nice. Okay, so just dropped a few of those shops in there. We're going to do some more detailing around that. And I've just switched this around as well, so it's facing the front over here, so the trucks aren't coming inside. And then what I'd also like to do is get a metro in here to help people get over here, because it is sort of out on a limb. We do have access to the highway, but as we mentioned at the beginning, we've got this metro line that runs underneath. And the one I'm thinking of using is this one from the sports venues pack, and that is just going to mess all of those lines up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove all of that so we can play with it a bit. We are going to take a 2U road with grass, and I'd like to make a little straight section out of here. Let's just delete that and try that again. So we go like that, and like that. Yeah, there we go. That'll be fine. And then we can hopefully fit that in there, more or less in the center, something along those lines. Yep, looking good. And I remember with this, there is a variation. I know it said Stadium Station, but you know, don't mind the name. Ooh, that looks interesting. That looks interesting. I'm wondering whether that one goes well, because we've got all the white buildings going on around here. What do you reckon? This sort of matches the color of those, and it's a little bit lower down. This one is a little bit too modern. We're going to go with this one. Got all the nice trees on the road as well. Yep, that's all lined up nicely. Let's get these hooked up underneath. There we go, that should be okay. And then if we let that run, we should be able to grab the line there and add a stop in. There we go. So now we can get some stops in here as well. Excellent. That all hooks up okay, doesn't it? And there's the metro going past. Oh, this is looking nice. I'm liking that. Very good, very good. So I'm just wondering now whether just to move this over here a bit, just to give this a little bit more breathing space, because let's grab that. So I'm trying to sort of get like maybe like a mini plaza shopping area together over there once you've come out of the train station. I think that'll be okay. Let's move that over a bit. We've got this path that comes out the back, which I also think we can add in. We've got to add in a load of paths. Let's get the move it mods. There we go. So we'll shift that there, and then we'll just start adding some paths everywhere to increase the walkability as well. Which is good. The parking is being well used over here. I don't know why people are driving over the parking spaces. Please don't do that. That is not the way to get around and to make friends with people. But yeah, hopefully this will drop down a bit. I mean, it's not super busy, is it? But hopefully that'll drop down a bit now that we've got the metro connection over here as well. And we've got a load of flickering going on. I feel like I need to reload my game. Restarted my game. And also, thank you very much to Chameleon for letting me know that the Acme camera mod, if you adjust your near clip distance from, I think it's normally a 1.2 or something like that, put it up to 2 meters, and then you'll find that the flickering disappears. Well, it has for me anyway, and it's looking good. So we're about to do a big detailing time lapse. And one thing I just noticed is I had the parking on this side of the road, but people are parking right outside their places over there. And just on a little bit of detailing over here, we've got these planter networks, which are nice. I just put along there, popped a load of paths in all over the place. You might upgrade those ones to ones with trees. Gonna put some park in there. We've also got these tiles that are underneath, which come with the pedestrian plazas and promenades DLC, which I think look really nice on the bottom of these, and allows people to use the garages as well. We're going to sort of ignore the fact that they're going to be sat on their balconies looking out that side, because people are going to be... I'm just wondering whether this whole thing needs to switch around the other way. Do you know what? Maybe not. We'll leave it like it is. We'll say people are looking out their front. But mainly, if you're this close to the beach, you are going down the beach, aren't you? Okay, so let us do some detailing. Going to move all the parking over here as well. And then, yeah, we'll see what it looks like at the end. So would you come and stay in these condos? Let me know in the comments below. By the way, I flipped them around so their balconies are facing out to sea and the wonderful view of New Tealand. Thank you very much for watching and your continued support on my channel. It's really appreciated. Subscribe and then watch the next video on the screen. I'll see you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.